I made this game engine in JavaScript and C++. I spent a little under a year creating this, all by myself in VS Code. Later in this video, I'll give you some demos as well as some insight into what I learned. It all started during a spring break in college. I decided to use my free time on making a custom renderer. I was able to render a wireframe 3D model, but I decided to switch to OpenGL. And then I decided instead to just switch to a renderer called Filament. Filament is a renderer developed and maintained by Google, and therefore has a lot of useful features like physically based materials, anti-aliasing, post-processing, etc. But it's missing some things I would like. Take a look at this comparison. The thing that is missing is global illumination. This is lighting that happens because of light bouncing around in a scene. And in the image on the right, you can see me trying to fake these with lights. But at the end of the day, I was able to render a texture square with lighting and shadows, all done without needing to write a ton of code. After that, my spring break was over, but I kept wondering if I could create my own game engine, an online game. In order to make an online game, we need to send and receive states of my game over the internet. I chose to do this by using the Steam networking library. I used the Steam networking library because it can ensure that players and servers are protected while providing high performance and reliability. However, just walking around in game isn't really all that fun, so I decided to add things like walls and other objects that can hurt you. You can prevent players from going through walls and objects by using a physics simulation. Furthermore, I used Box 2D for this. After adding this into the game engine, players were able to push each other, use bows and arrows, and swords. With Box 2D, the game was starting to take shape into something that was more than just walking around with friends. However, I noticed a problem pretty quickly. Say for example, you wanted to pick up an object, and you wanted the player to hold down a button in order to pick it up. To do that, there's a ton of different systems that need to interact with each other. This often requires waiting for multiple systems to play out, like the player moving in range, the player pressing the button, timer to stop, etc. This can be made easier by creating multiple variables that are created and discarded dynamically. C++ has a lot of problems when it comes to handling this kind of logic. Managing things like lifetimes with quarantines or futures is pretty hard to do in a safe manner while using C++. By the way, don't worry if you didn't understand that last part. But the reason why it's so tricky in C++ is because of the manual memory management that can be pretty hard to not mess up. However, by using a scripting language, the process can be easily streamlined. There's also the problem with the fact that C++ can easily take a long time to compile, and that can hurt your focus or productivity. So I looked for some alternatives and settled on using JavaScript. But when I made the decision to go with JavaScript, my friends would ask, why not Lua? Why not Python? Why not Dart, C#? Or Java? Why not just rewrite everything in Rust? I actually spent a few weeks on the question of what language to use. Some game engines use their own scripting languages, but I didn't want to go that route because an already made language would have community support with things like libraries and tooling. The reason why I went with JavaScript is that there's a lot of great libraries, tools, and support thanks to the fact that it's ubiquitous across the web. Alright, time for some demos. So the first thing I'm going to show is about the sun. So if you type in the sun, it will give you an object and you can take a look at what's in that object. See, there's two functions. So I'm going to set the intensity of the sun and you can instantly see the change in the lighting. There's also another important function that you'll be using called setTimer. So I'm going to make a variable called direction and I'm going to make a new function called animateDirection. Then we will set a timer that will call the function animateDirection and we will do this every 15 milliseconds. Now finally, I'm going to actually call the function animateDirection. And as you see here, we are animating the direction of the sun and you can see how it changes the lighting over time. I think it looks pretty cool. With that choice out of the way, I needed to choose a JavaScript library that can be added into my game engine. There's QuickJS, Ducktape, Hermes, and V8. I decided to choose V8 because it's the most widely used of all these choices. V8 is actually a pretty easy library to use. It's what I would have said if I wasn't so sure that this was a good idea. But now, I'm not sure if I made a big mistake. This is because V8 was not easy to add into my project. There was a ton of different problems, mostly stemming from how the V8 build system builds V8. No, seriously, V8 is just built different. I believe that V8 has a build system written by the devil himself. This build system from hell had me tearing my hair out for multiple weeks straight. With each attempt to add it into my game engine, it required me to sit waiting for hours for it to compile, only for it to give me an error. After spending weeks on the problem, I finally got to work and ran some JavaScript code in my game engine. And that's where the project ended. I think you can see why I somewhat regret my decision. Other than the build system, V8 isn't a bad library to use. I was able to add it into my game engine easily after the build system issues. And in a few days, I was able to add some JavaScript functions that work with my game engine's asynchronous timer system and its GUI. I planned on adding some more JavaScript functions, but I was starting to feel burnt out on the idea of making my own game engine. Mostly because there wasn't a ton of focus on the game, which I had to rewrite several times as each new system was added. It just wasn't a stable foundation to build a game on top of. And I was spending far too much time on the tech that was driving the game instead of the actual game itself. By the time I got to this point, I felt like I needed to stop and get a job. But now it's been a bit less than 2 years since then. But recently, I decided to pick up Unity again. I used to use the Unreal Engine, but I was shocked by how much I actually liked Unity more than Unreal Engine. This mostly came down to the flexibility and ease of use that came from Unity's C# scripting. I was easily able to iterate much more rapidly with Unity, but I don't dislike the Unreal Engine. In my opinion, it's just more artist-friendly and artist-focused, while Unity is much more easier for the programmer. By the way, this was written before Unreal Engine 5 was released, but my opinion hasn't really changed. Generally speaking though, I felt that even if this didn't amount to much, it taught me a lot about the inner workings of a game engine, and the problems that you have to solve when making a game engine. There are definitely some things I would do differently, like using the entity component system pattern. Instead of defining things by a type, they're defined by components that make up a thing. The entities have components. Components would contain data, and the code would be the systems. For example, an NPC entity would have a body for physics, a sprite for rendering, and a health counter. There would be systems that calculated the physics of the bodies, one that rendered the sprites, etc. My game engine had a similar system, but it didn't have components. Everything in the scene would have a type, and each type would have its own list of objects that had that type. But by separating things into entities and components, you can get a list of components with the same or multiple types using a single function that works for all types of components. This also allows each system to have its own job or thread, making multi-threading much easier. I could have also chosen a different JavaScript engine, like Hermes or QuickJS, and this would save myself from weeks of suffering. Unless Google gets their act together by getting a holy cross to remove all the demons from V8. But I will probably stick with pre-made game engine, and I might make some game announcements here. So make sure you're subscribed so that you don't miss any information about those. And take a look at this other video where I make a Discord bot that runs on the 3DS.